Hey guys, welcome back to Rames English. Today we'll practice grammar and the topic is phrase versus clause. This is part one. To me, phrase and clause always have an eternal battle.
Oh no, don't worry.
This is not the real battlefield, but this is the battlefield of language because most of the time people tend to make mistakes in identifying phrase and clause. As they look similar, but there are differences, of course. So today I'll show you how to identify phrase and clause.
Because
when you go for sentence making, you must use phrase and clause. Now let's start. At first, let us know what is called a phrase. Phrase means simply a group of words. Here you will get several words together. But there is no subject-verb combination. This is important definition for phrase. In the phrase, that means in the group of words, you will not get any subject-verb combination. And it doesn't express proper meaning or doesn't make any sense. So simply, phrase means a group of words where there will be no subject-verb given together and where you will not get any meaning. Now let me give you some examples. On the table. Here you see we are using just a group of words, but it doesn't make any sense because there is no subject-verb combination given. Her friend. Here again we are using words without any proper meaning and there is no subject-verb combination. By the river. Here there is no subject and verb given.
Going home.
Here only words without any meaning and subject-verb combination. By the way, if you do not know what is called a subject or what is called a verb, you can check my video on sentence. Then I hope your idea about subject and verb will be clear. So if we consider all these four examples, it is clear that these are called phrases. Because these are group of words, then there is no subject-verb combination and they do not express any proper meaning or they do not make any kind of sense. Now let us know what is a clause. A clause means group of words. This is similar with phrase. In the phrase also we get group of words, but the difference is here. Clause has subject-verb combination, which is absent in phrase. Clause may express complete meaning, but not all the time. Sometimes you will find clause is independent, where it is expressing a complete meaning. Sometimes you will find clause is dependent on another sentence, and it is used as part of the sentence. It depends on the structure of the sentence, of course. Now let me give you the examples. I saw him yesterday. Here, I is the subject and saw is the verb. This is the past form of present verb, see. So in this sentence, we are getting a complete meaning. We are getting subject-verb combination and it is a group of words. So obviously, this is a clause. You do it now. Here, you is the subject. And do is the verb. And it is a complete sentence. And you can see at the end there is full stop given. It means that it is expressing a complete meaning. So this is a clause. They go to the park daily. Again here it is expressing complete meaning. And we are getting the subject they and verb go. And this is a group of words. So this is a clause. When he was eating, here you can see a comma given. So we can understand that it is not giving us a complete meaning and it is not a complete sentence. And this is called dependent clause because this is working just a part of another sentence. But we are getting a group of words and we are getting subject-verb combination. Here, he is the subject, was is the auxiliary verb, and eating is the ing. Form of the main verb eat. So if we consider all these four examples, we can easily understand these are all clauses. because they are group of words, they have subject-verb combination, and they sometimes express meaning also. Now, I'll give you more examples and I'll show you side by side how to identify phrase and how to identify clauses. Now see, reading a book. This is a phrase because there is no subject-verb combination given and it is not expressing a complete meaning. On the other hand, while I was reading a book, here we are getting subject. I is the subject, was is the auxiliary verb, and reading is the ing form of the main verb, read. But this is not expressing a complete meaning because this is working as part of another sentence or another clause. In front of. Here we can easily understand there is no subject-verb combination given. This is just a group of words and it doesn't express any complete meaning. But you are in front of me. Here we are getting the subject you. Verb is are. So this is a clause. And remember one thing. When you find there is no other main verb given in the sentence, that time auxiliary verb like am, is, are, was, were work as the main verb. Then my friend, here we are getting a group of words, but we are not getting any subject verb combination. So this is a phrase. I met my friend last week. Here we are getting subject verb combination because I is the subject and met is the verb. This is the past form of meet. And it is expressing a complete meaning. So this is undoubtedly a clause. Like my brother. No subject-verb combination. So this is a phrase and it doesn't make any sense also. He is like my brother. Here he is the subject. Is the verb. As I mentioned earlier, when there is no main verb given in the sentence or in the clause, auxiliary verb works as the main verb. So here is the main verb. Very swiftly. Here also we are getting group of words without any proper meaning, without any subject-verb combination. So this is a phrase. Ella writes very swiftly. Here Ella is the subject and writes is the verb. So we are getting subject-verb combination and this is expressing a full meaning. And this is a group of words also. So this is a clause. So everyone, I hope your ideas about phrases and clauses are clear now. Now it's your turn. Here you get 5 exercises. Try to find out which ones are phrases and which ones are clauses. And to think about this, I'm giving you 10 seconds. So your time starts now. Okay, time's up. Now let's check back the answer. No sound. What do you think? What should be the answer? Yes, you are absolutely right. The answer is phrase because there is no subject-verb combination given. This is simply a group of words without any meaning. The boy has a toy. Yes, you are right. This is a clause because here we are getting subject boy. And has is the verb. If you want to go. Yes, you are right. This is a clause. Because here you are getting subject, you. And verb is want. Though it is not expressing complete meaning. Because it is incomplete. And this clause will work as part of another clause. Inside the room. This is obviously a phrase. Because there is no subject-verb combination given. And it doesn't have a proper meaning. A new book. Yes, your answer is correct. This is a phrase because we are not getting any subject-verb combination here. This is just a group of words and it doesn't express any complete meaning. So everyone, that's all about phrase and clause. In my next video, in part 2, you will come to know different types of phrases and clauses.
So everyone, till then, bye-bye. Thank you for watching. Please hit the like button, share the video, and don't forget to subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon.